Hello everyone, I'm in Fisher Online and I'm continuing my small species tour, and in this video I am in USA and I'm gonna show what small species I caught here in USA. The USA is a DLC lake and is basically three tiddlers, really small stuff that I go for here, and then of course I also go for the bass here. And the first one I want to talk about is these guys, the golden shiners. With the setups and baits I'm going to show you, you will catch a lot of these guys. And usage for these guys, there is two things that you use them for. Firstly, you cut them up for live bait. If you go to your cutting table, your shiner live bait, and you can cut them up for live bait. And of course this golden shiners is one of the main baits here in USA for various different species, but they also work very well in other lakes as well. The important thing I want to note here is don't cut your shiners that's bigger than 100 gram. All your shiners 100 gram and above, keep them, because there is very regularly income quests here for shiners. Like you see this one here, I already took it, where only two of these small shiners, 139 silver. So apart from the bait you can get from them, you can get some decent silver on these income quests for the golden shiners, and they are usually from around here 92-96 gram. So what I do, I keep all my shiners that's around 96 grams and upwards, I keep them and I hand them in for these income quests to make some decent silver. To such small fish, 139 silver is really good silver for such small fish. Then the second species is the rainbow smelts. Now the rainbow smelts, the main use for them is also quests. You regularly get income quests on these guys as well. So then you hand in your rainbow smelts for the income quests, and also regularly you have them on a daily. Then the third very small one we're looking at is the black crappies. Now the black crappies also, this one also you have income quests for them. But something important here, all your blue variants, the large size crappies, do not give them for quests, because sell these guys at the normal fish shop. These guys fetch really good silver, these blue black crappies. So all your greens and whites, you can give them in for quests, especially the income quests. They have good income quests of over 200 silver. But these blues, all your blues, you keep them and you sell them back at the fish store, because they fetch you some really nice silver that they get. Don't give your blues away for quests. Then you will also catch some, quite a bit of these guys, the yellow perches. You can also, I mostly sell them. They do have a quest now and then, but not as much as the other three. You will also pick up some bluegills. The bluegills also has very good income quests, most of these small ones, guys. Here in USA with these small fishes, always keep an eye on your quests, especially the income quests. All of them have really good income quests, and I'm being attacked here by a bee. So that is what I mainly use these small species here for. I hand them in for income quests, and most of them is from 140 and 200 silver. That's really good money for such small fish. And then of course we will also look a bit at the bass, the smallmouth basses and the white bass, as well as the black bass. Now the setups I use, for the tiddlers I use around, again, around 6 kilograms setups with 6.4 liters. I use size 0 hook because these guys are really small. I don't go higher than size 0. And then the baits, I use mealworms. Mealworms works the best here. And this one you buy in USA itself. Then the second bait that works well is the bladworm. This one is especially good for the rainbow smelt. So if you have a rainbow smelt daily, for example, you can put a lot of rods bladworm. The bladworm catch a lot of rainbow smelts. And then other baits that also work well is your maggot. Your maggots work also well, and your lava bark beetle, they also work. So you can use all four those baits, but the mealworms are the best one. They are basically dedicated for this lake. I always have one of my rods, I have mealworms on it, and then the others I will put either a maggot and a bloodworm on the others. Then for the bass I target with lure fishing. I basically use two main lures that I use. The first one is this jig brush S2. These brush jigs, and these ones you buy here in USA. And I use the S2 version or variant. And I pair that with the brush jig H size 110 gram. That's what I pair it with. Now these, you have to use these special brush jigs to use that brush lure, and you buy these in USA itself. Now you can, on this brush jig, you can go up to a number 2, a size 2, but I found on a size 2 that my bite rate goes down a bit. And during this tour, the main idea is to have lots of fun and catch lots of fish, so I use this size 1. Then the second lure I use is our good friend, the topwater cockchafer. This one also works very well for a bass here, so I alternate the two. I would use the brush jig, and if the brush jig gets a bit quiet, then I will switch to this one and see if this one goes better. Usually this one is also very, very effective here. Then where I fish these small guys, now you can fish them right here at spawn, anywhere from this docks, this whole area around here, you can fish for these guys. This whole area here will work. But me, I prefer to go right, come right down here to A5, to the bass spot we all know. And the reason for this is because I target my third rod, I always target bass with. I put two feeders out for the tiddlers, and then on my third rod I spin for the bass. And there's two reasons for that. Because the feeders, even though it's tiddlers, they sometimes can have a slow bite rate. So I like to use a third rod to spin with that to keep busy. And secondly, the bass, lots of fun to catch, and they give a lot of good money, especially the smallmouth bass gives a lot of good money. So that's where I'm sitting here in A5. From the docks you drive out to the right, and you will see this where the little river just starts to begin. And I'm right here at the start of here, there's where the river starts. Now I throw, what I do, I get my two feeders out. I just throw them close to the lilies and the grasses there. That's the two rods for the tiddlers, and then my third rod. My third rod I will just spin around here. And you can cast this whole area here. This whole area here is full of bass. So this is the first stop in the tour, where you're catching small species, but you're actually making good money with it, because all the tiddlers have really good income quests here, and all your bass you sell normally at the shop, and they give good money. especially your small mouths, they give really good money. There we got the little yellow perch. And sometimes what they even do, and these tiddlers on the feeders, they bite really strange. Sometimes you get heavy activity where they bite non-stop for a little while, maybe 5 or 10 minutes, and then they get quiet again. And that's when I do the most of my bass fishing. There's a nice large white bass. But you can even, if the two feeders with the small species, if they get too busy, you can even take them out and just sit and catch your bass. That's also another option. But you see, this is really nice while I'm waiting for that feeders to bite. Then I'm catching the bass, and the bass is really, really good silver here. So with all of these small stuff, you make really nice silver. And for guys who are still doing leveling, you're making nice XP as well, especially on the bass. You're making some nice XP as well. Here we've got the large black bass, we've got the large white bass, large black bass. Let's do just a couple of casts more. One of our small guys is going again. Then we got the shiner. And I catch all those species here, the shiners, the black crappies, the rainbow smelts. Basically all those that I catch here. They are a bit slower than they would be at the docks, around the docks area. Around the docks area you catch a little bit more of them. But I like this spot because of the extra option of the bass fishing. Got another one on the bass jig. So with this spot, I don't mind if the feeders get quiet, because I'm constantly now, there we have the third species of bass as well, with the smallmouth bass. So with this spot, I don't mind if the feeders goes a bit quiet, because I keep busy with the bass, I'm still having fun with the bass. And there we got the rainbow smelt as well. So that's the small species tour here in USA, guys. Okay, here we got another one on the mealworms. This one also is fair amount of fun. The feeders can at times get a bit quiet, and then at other times they go crazy and you catch tons of stuff. But when the feeders go, the bass themselves is fairly consistent bite rate, so if the feeders goes a bit quiet, you still get a lot of bass. So overall, it was a fair amount of fun, my stop here at USA, and I did make quite a bit of good silver here, mostly with the income quests and the smallmouth bass that I sold. So that's it for this one, guys. Have fun, tight lines. I will see you again. Cheers.